Security teams have known that Kaspersky has been a risk for almost 10 years, but if you're still getting rid of it now that it's banned, it's time to get it done. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. Kaspersky Labs is now officially banned in the US. The Biden administration has officially prohibited the sale and update of all antivirus software products from the Russian firm Kaspersky. You might know this because all the news outlets have been repeating it, and the Department of Homeland Security prohibited the vendor in 2017. But if you've been caught by surprise by this news, here's what you need to do next. First, you must find an alternate vendor. We put together a quick list for reference, and there's a link in the description. But the idea is that you assess your options, find a vendor that works within your budget, preferences, and other constraints, particularly security. And then secondly, once you have a vendor selected, you'll need to, of course, remove Kaspersky from your systems. And you'll likely do this the same way you got it installed, via a script or your application management system or Intune or some other method of remote installation. And we'll leave a quick deployment reference here in case you need it. And then lastly, you'll need to get the solution installed. From there, you'll probably just need to make sure that people can't install or use Kaspersky again, particularly if you give your customers admin rights to their machines, if you're crazy enough to do that. To accomplish this, you'll need a way to keep track of what is installed on your assets, which is kind of the whole point behind InvGate Insight. So for instance, you could create a smart tag to automatically label new Kaspersky installations as unauthorized software and send an alert to your team. If you haven't heard of us, give it a try at try.invgate.com. I think we can all agree that antivirus is still a necessary service that IT provides to control endpoints and keep corporate data safe. For more on this topic and for other IT news, check out our blog, the InvGate blog at blog.invgate.com. I hope you found this video informative, and I hope to see you again soon.